Oh, hey, I've been there too. And watch this, I'm running Windows 11 on what's supposed to be a unsupported device. But listen friend, my name is Kensley, and if you have the time, let me show you how you can update your computer too. So, let's get started. One intro. Before we start, you'll need to download this for me. PC Health Checker, but don't worry, we're not going to put some nasty needles inside you. Rufus, and I don't know. And last, the ISO of Windows 11. And don't worry, everything is linked down in the description. And you'll need an external drive with at least 8 gigs of storage. And as a disclaimer, I've already upgraded my computer, and I forgot to record the process, so take everything with a grain of salt, please. Okay, the technicalities out of the way. First, download the Windows 11 ISO. And while it's downloading, let me show you my hardware specs in order for you to have realistic expectations. Now watch, if I launch PC Health Picker, you'll see that the only listed problem is my processor, and I know for a fact that it's not the problem. Next, if I go to Windows Security, Device Security, Security Processor Details, you can see that the specification version of the TPM is 2.0, and if we go back, Secure Boot is also on. So these are kinda the requirements, so if you don't have them, still try, but I think that maybe we'll need another video. I don't know if it works for you. Good. Now let's get back to the files we've downloaded, and let's begin to install Windows 11. And yeah, I think you're old enough and I don't need to ask you to back up your important files, right? Just in case everything just goes south. Okay, now open Rufus. Open Rufus. Device is the external drive, boot selection, the ISO we've just downloaded. So let's select it and follow my lead. My system is somewhat modern, so GPT is the ideal partition scheme for the installation, and my ISO drive is formatted with that partition scheme. Let me show you real quick. Windows X, disk management, disk properties, audio, then double click on the drive, then go to volume. If nothing is shown, click on the populate button and you'll see that my drive was partitioned using GPT. So let me get that please. And my target system is set to UEFI. Again, if I go to system information, my BIOS mode is UEFI. So I'm going to press start, and when the process is complete, I'm going to eject the drive and restart my computer to boot on the USB drive. But remember, if that doesn't work, maybe change the order at which the